before I start the talk, I would like to acknowledge the value of the information from our events and the information on the topic. And I would like to thank the colleagues and the support of the group of Asian so, I guess you all have seen this. looking back at this week's talks, I don't have to introduce Dr. Judit to this audience. But nonetheless, I would like to say a few words just to take a moment. So, as normal, astrologists have been very important to distinguish different things of matter. But, of course, there are the same strategy, but as David said, and to be able to distinguish between them, we need to brains. So, originally in geology, we can use, for example, the Romhanyi program to distinguish using the surfaces by integrating the curvature over this closed surface. And this will give us the number of the handles. And also approach with the brain. Very similarly, in quantum mechanics, instead of the curvature, we can just integrate the very curvature over the frequency one to characterize the bands. And then we will get a true number, which is another topological invariant in all integral values. In that sense, the integral quantum contact, this problem happens to nothing but an integer number that characterizes the space. So, what most of the cases we have introduced is something very complicated, but in fact, at the end, we would like to describe two bands. and very general two bands can be written in this way simply before. For example, Mars and Earth, and then solar point is here, this is after. There's no case of the parameters. And also is momentum dependent. And also the sigma correlations is that represent these two bands that we want to discuss. So it's very simple to diagonalize the sigma domain. And once we do it, the eigenvalues you just have to see before are that the constant that is shifted by the length of the sigma vector. So it's easy to see that whenever for some set of parameters, for a given key point, this zero vanishes, and the two bands are going to eventually form this zero point. But even for density two after is larger than zero, then the bands are constrained, and the chirp number is well defined. So this is practically the equation that I'm going to use throughout my talk, and I will try to render it. So, since the discovery of topological insulators, fine momentum analogs has been very popular, I think, and there's been really a lot of work in this direction. I would just like to flash a few of them, for example, the observation of the quantum contact with this five-four contact was one of the first observations. And the white ones is really five-four, and the quantum analogs from the white value. On device that does. Also, there's a picture of how one can realize the body model in on the filament insulators because we have fundamentally this system. This contrast hopping is not really realized in these systems. So, there have been actually many other works in this direction, and they've led to. This picture, using the local temperament quantum mechanics in freedom, can be generalized to larger space. But instead of having one which is here, you can just have this spin x or z component in the larger spin. And the solution for this function still has the same form of circuitry. But now have here M, but this is just the S, C eigenvalue. And instead of having just two bands, we can have two S plus one levels that will not speed 1 and speed 2 of the processor. So I will start with the short, I'm sorry for going through this. I think I don't know this is going to be everywhere. But nonetheless, for the same thing. The first copper is a layer container, but the strontium and the copper terminals are layers of the thing. And this is the important layer for us. In this, the copper ions form proton and ion lattice. And this module actually is a physical derivation of the model of proton supernova layers, where the proxy is exactly one. So we have first neighbor and second neighbor interaction boson quantity, and for a certain time of G has G, the proxy is going to be the same property of the lattice. So if this could be the case, and that the expectations of this system, which can be imagined as being of single state looking down on two lattice that would be localized. And there is a very simple strategy for this. For example, this mirror plate here is symmetry of the system, and it means that the opening, so if I plan to have opening in this case and this one, which means that the then these two states should have the same transformation under the symmetry of the Hamiltonian. But because the signal is what can do the same here. So clearly we have to determine the superconditions, and there will be no G7 developed by the symmetry. So in that sense, on the spectrum, neutral spectrum, we would be reporting. I would just have a 6-well ordinary chiplet that here, that would not be distributed in the world, because chiplets are localized. And in case of a system something like this, the two further measurements. But instead of this picture, what you see is that these two events are actually non-degenerate and they're dispersing. And also, this splitting, as I mentioned here, is going to be observed in the image of spectrum as well. So, here the as much as other model is not enough to characterize the system, and we need to choose non-entropies in the form of Topological signal information. So once we take a full Hamiltonian like this, these D vectors are actually used by the symmetry, and the ground state is not a pure signal for the state, but instead we have on both A and B surfaces some triplet mixing with signals. And I would like to point out that here we use now. Thank you for the thesis for the triplets, which makes our life a lot easier because depending on which one we are doing, the Joshua's memorial is different, and that means that I will either use D by the X for the triplets. So, to describe the situation now, instead of the triplets, we have the triplet buildings, which is also one of these states, and these are actually. Now, they get dispersed because my signal equipment before is not working anymore because I don't have pure signals such as the system. And we can always be upgraded to depend. That's what is now. And what we find is that along the border of the horizon, it's very fundamental as long as nothing more switches to the ground. And that means that instead of having six modes like this one, you can just use a simplification and unfold this period and so on. And then just instead of having six simplifications of this kind of plant, we just need to think it's real. And this we can do by, so this is the original renaissance we want, and by unfolding, we work in an involved renaissance features. And that I can cut out my bands and all the so instead of having six repetitions, I only need three of them. And that makes our life much easier and also the distribution more relevant. So this is the triplet Hamiltonian. And we can find much nicer for these matrices that are three of them. This is actually the S2s of the S3. So these behave as a spin one. And then you can just write the homing here into the original form that I showed at the beginning. So there is a constant, there is a key vector that acts like a sort of quality field, and it covers the three component of this spin one. So compared to the key vector is first of all information about the topological properties. And if the bands are approaching non-clear, then floating T vectors give the float skirmion in the console. And you can bring actually the expression from the Chern order into this very simple form, but this is just minus two times the S in one because that is two one excitation factor here, that if M is minus 1, 0 of the constant, and therefore we will have so another way of representing the proportional properties is by drawing this surface that is mapped out by the three vectors if you draw them in one region. And whenever this origin is inside the surface, we are in proportion to the non-trivial regime. And the origin is outside, then that's a so, changing the magnetic field, we can do this band touching phase position. And zero magnetic field bands are touching here, forming this spin one here one. And when the magnetic field is increased for a smaller magnetic field, we have a full gap between the bands and bands are touching one here. At the critical point, we will get a critical point, and after that, the bad side will merge the non-trivial. So, this actually is the outcome here, has been in the ESR spectrum on long, but we just need to think about it as a critical point. So, we can understand the switching in the following way. Here, at the 0 point, we see that the red and the blue bands have the same energy. So, these are the if I pull this now back, then it's again the same number one. So these are the same measure. If I increase one to field, then the rest will be split. So this is over 10 again. These 2 points, and the blue ones similarly. And at the critical point, one of the red ones and one of the blue ones are mixed. It's here at this point. And again, increasing one to field, we're just So this is actually only the measurement of this temperature transition and the topology is not happening. So when the magnetic field is large, then we are outside of the topology of the field. And the origin of the G-vector is outside of the surface. As we increase the magnetic field, bands are touching the single point from the zero point. When the magnetic field is small enough, we are inside the surface and the bands are converging to each other. And then at zero magnetic field, here we have again the magnetic transition. As the magnetic field direction is changed, the two bands, the two bands will be exchanged. What was plus with minus now. And again, increasing the magnetic field further, so correspondingly in an open system we expect edgeons, and because the turnover is positive minus, so we will have two that are positive velocity and two that are negative velocity. So that means that we have two left-handed edgeons on opposite edges of the sample. networks and networks. So since it's further, there has been aspect of the observation of this emerging of the side. So now I'd like to move on to the topology, where this is just a general extension of the previous model. So this is going to be, instead of having ladders, now we have three spins that are in the top of the and so in this meeting model, we have again the entry time. The data is stronger than the direction of the time because the system is standardized. And we have characterized the select system by giving these triangles as the element of the configuration. So by using the symmetry, the three one halves produce this, like at least if you have two dots and and adding the molecular symmetry of that is, you can see that this two will actually transform as well as the similar representation. That means that the data will be generated. So the spectrum is very simple form, but the non trivial number. We have two dots out here. And so, of course, we have two trans one of the activities because we need all the trans ones to update each other. So, we need to add trans more interactions that we have from the data. And also, because these data actually higher. And here is the only direction, but here is a particular domain. We split the higher states. For example, under the energy, then the states in the positive priority will go down. And now I can use a man on the field to fully split these bands because as you can see, all of them have different density components. So anyone in the field, I have a fully split so first, I will just take a completely wondering what's happening when we try to spread the decisions in the system. So the lowest band was generated band, and I improved the interaction before we don't say state the two side of an overall component configuration. This is actually a kind of magnetic state, and when I have magnetic field perpendicular to somebody, you let an umbrella and get comfort. And then the overall state is out of this group. It's just an all of the aspects are coming in. So we can, if you mention the low end expectations of the way, in the ground state, all of the triangles are in this whole out state. And the expectation is by breaking this out and putting this other state that is kind of propagating. So this is just a practically a triangular that is problem of the fact is in one half. And the higher modes, you can actually these ones, without the testing ones that we talk about from Japan. We can just write more big time between for them, checking a similar that for the triplets of the shape, which is the that. And we have the same number of them, but now this S, the diverse spin of the characterizes these two bands, or the spin speed that we characterize these four bands on here. So formally, it's really the same. And then as it turns out, these two actually are going to be topologically non trivial one way when I introduce them to the field. Until it actually is only softer and they go into different phase. So the topology of these two lines will not change before the ground state actually changes. For the three half lines, we have these larger Chern numbers. Because the Chern number, of course, here is again minus and times add times number of skeletons, so that there is one skeleton formed by the skeletons. And J is from minus about plus 3 is a equalization. And very similar to the previous case, we have a multipolar transition tuned by the field. So every one of the field will be a band here. When one of the field is finite or small enough, then these bands are fully split, and we have the large Chern numbers. Critical point in the Dutch, either the K or K endpoint, or changing my configuration to the K endpoint. sides at this corresponding to this anti-regular triangle, then I can use the string precision to prioritize these ones. And actually, for example, for these ones, I don't know if this is going to be the left or not. So this is the R, this is the L, this is the left and right. To the left side of the sample. And these are actually very polar edge states. And we can have some polar polar ones as well. And why I think this is interesting is because these polar polar things, they have not very tangible resilience, but they live on the edge of the sample where the inversion symmetry is anyway wrong. So one can imagine that you can have more interaction coupling, and maybe there will be another experiment that's interesting, and not just the thermal pole effect. And have some maybe optical tool by the electric component to this polar polar state. And so I would like to summarize the talk. I would like to attempt to introduce some generalization of the known polar larger states and show that there are some more interaction. And maybe because of the multiple characters of this band, maybe the band will be better than some other experiments.
For this green parallel that all they consider.
Yes, it's not a scalar equation.
So actually